Now look, let's look at the screen and some of our panel over here. Now this is a touch panel, so you're going to use your finger to select the different things on here. First, when you're starting off, what I want you to do is just have a look at the screen. Now you can see here that we've got like a set of 9 squares. That's representative that we're going to be working from this area here for our stitches. So it's number 1 lot of stitches there. Over here it tells me that there's 2 hearts there. What that means is that we're going to have a full line of stitching when we're doing our stitches. And we've got the needle down position that we've set, and so that's showing there. For every stitch that I change on the machine will tell me what foot to use. And you can see here that there aren't any changes. Oh, there we go, that one's changed to a G foot. So just at a glance you can see that, okay, for that particular stitch I need to put my G foot on. Then it automatically sets the width and the length for me. So what I'm going to do is just go back to my straight stitch here. Now on this side we're selecting, this is where we're going to select our buttonholes from here, and this is our decorative stitches, and so this is where our stitch card comes into its own. So it's showing us the direct stitches are from here, so that's these ones. This one here gives us the ones on here, because in a moment we're going to do a buttonhole. And then this one is like the different ones that we've got here, and the number 3 different decorative stitches. And of course this machine does have it has the alphabet on here, so you can do a couple of different fonts. Great for doing name badges. So we're just going to, or name tags that we can do on there. This one, it says to cancel or go back. Okay, we're happy with that. But these ones here, like, I wouldn't worry too much about these. They do explain them in the handbook for you. This one brings it back to a default. So sometimes when I'm doing my dressmaking, I do use this one, because this is where I can save my setting in the machine. Now these are the most important ones that I like to play with. So with this one, it's going to set an automatic reverse on here, and also the scissors on here as well. Now we're on a straight stitch, and you're thinking, okay, it's got up here with the width and the length of the stitch. Yes, I can change the length, but I understand that on a straight stitch. Now with the width on the straight stitch, well, you don't need a width as such, but what it does, it moves our position of our needle. So as we're looking at the needle itself, you can see how it's moving right from the left hand position over to the right hand position. When do we need that? Say we're going to be putting in a zipper, or we're going to be doing some top stitching. So we're able to use our markings on our foot, or the clear part of our foot as a guide, and then we can move the needle exactly where we're needing it to go. You're not sure where it was originally, so just select the number 1 stitch again. But if you're wanting the needle to go into the middle, of course you're going to use your number 3, which gives you your center needle position. But we're going to start by using our left hand needle position. So because we've got our reverse, I'm going to select my reverse here. So what it's going to do, it's going to automatically do my reverse in the beginning. And then when I'm getting to the end of my seam, I'm going to just press my reverse button here once, and it beeps, and it does 3 stitches backwards, 3 stitches forwards, and then it stops. And then I'm going to press my scissors. So it automatically does this for me. Now what I'm going to do now, I'm going to go in and I'm going to do my reverse to start off with. Come down to the end, press my reverse here. But what it's going to do for me, it's going to cut the thread this time. So voila, all done. So I don't have to worry about touching any of these buttons here because I've got this selected. So you can do that on any stitch. Now, if I was going to finish off the edge of the fabric, now traditionally we would use a zigzag stitch, and it's already set to what the manufacturer thinks that is correct for a zigzag stitch. Cut my thread. But what I find with the zigzag stitch, that sometimes with a softer fabric it's going to pull it over. So that's why that I tend to use my three-step zigzag here. And the reason why it's called three-step zigzag, yes, because it does three steps as it goes over to form the stitch. So what I'm going to do this time, I'm going to take my reverse off because I don't want to do it to do a reverse on that edge. And what I'm going to do is just sew with it on that edge there. Cut the thread. I'm going to do that again. So I'm just going to sew with it on that edge, and then the threads come out of the needle. Rethread the machine. Cut the thread. Use my needle threader. Now what I'm going to align is to make sure that the right hand swing of my needle is going off the fabric. And I'll show you what I'm doing. So this is what I'm wanting, is it for it to be sitting right on that edge. So that's my three-step zigzag. I find that that's just that little bit better for holding the fibres of the fabric, especially when you're working with the linen like this, where it's very frayy with the fabric, so the fibres are going to pull out easily. But I find that this really holds the edges of the fabric really well. Another stitch which I like to use when in this standard sewing setting is this one here, which is your triple straight stitch here. Now what that does, and I'll show you as it's going around this seam, it actually does a stitch forward, backwards, and then forward again. Now the reason why that I use it for, say, the crotch of pants, or sometimes when I'm sewing in a sleeve, is because it is a reinforcing the seam. Most patterns tell you to double stitch your crotch seam, and also for putting your sleeves in, but when you're doing this stitch, it's not necessary to do that. And the reason why I use this stitch is because it not only has strength, but it has stretch as well, so it has give within the stitch. So how beautiful is that, and how good is that for a crotch seam?